Whilst we're on the subject of layers, I want to show you clipping and masking, and specifically the differences between them. I use this all the time, and many designers do as well. So we know how to group items, but we don't yet know how to fit this circle into this square, for instance. So I only see the square, but I can see the kind of circle hiding inside. So how we do that is, in the layers panel, you'll see that this circle is above the green square. Basically what we do, this is called clipping now, okay? So for clipping, we click and drag onto the layer, just like I am here, and let go. And you can kind of see it's made a group in the layers panel. But also, you can see that the circle is now hiding inside of the square. So we can move it around within there, and it's done exactly what we wanted it to. If you click away, and then you click back on, you can move this square around independently, and the circle moves with it. If I want to move the circle inside and change its location slightly, I could just double tap and get through to the layer inside. Now this is called a child layer. The circle is now a child layer. So if you look on the layers panel, we have our parent layer, which is the green square, and our child layer, which is the pink circle inside. Now, if I click on it again, there is a little option in the context toolbar that says lock children. So remember, the children is the actual child layer, the little circle inside. So if I click on that, and then I move this up and down, it's not manipulating the shape of that circle that we put in there. It's locked the child layer. But if I uncheck it, and then I go back down and squash it down, you see it's reacting with how I'm changing the shape of this square. So that is clipping. You clip a circle inside of a square. Now let's talk about masking. So let me just delete this one. Let's talk about masking this one here. So for this one, I want the blue circle to act as a mask so I can see through to the square. So what I will do is I'll go to the layers panel, I'll click on that, and I'll just drag it down and onto the actual icon. So I'm going onto the actual square this time, not over to the left. So onto that square, and I let go. And now you can see a mask has appeared. I can click on the drop down arrow, and I can see it there. Let's play around with it. So now I've clicked it. I'm basically looking through a hole, and I'm moving it around to reveal different parts of the square. This is called masking. And again, if I click off of it, and click back on, I can just play around with the square shape. And if I click on the actual mask layer in the layers panel, now I can move around the circle. This is really useful for photos, if you're trying to frame a photo in a circle, for instance.